So my name is Mary McMahon. I'm a postdoctoral researcher in the laboratory of Professor David Ruggero at University of California, San Francisco. And the question I'm really interested in addressing is how the process of making proteins is deregulated in disease. So normally, how our genetic template or our genes, how they are regulated to make protein, that is the final product of gene expression, and how this process can be altered in different diseases, particularly cancer. We have a lot of different model systems that we use in the lab. We also have collaborations with some hospitals and doctors where we can obtain specimens from patients that have disease. And, you know, we'll run certain assays on them, looking at our favorite protein of interest, looking at RNA. You know, we're trying to identify biomarkers, so we'll use those samples to see if we can see any difference between a normal patient sample and a patient from a disease sample. So I grew up on a farm in Ireland, and my father is a very passionate farmer, and, you know, at a young age I was exposed to a lot of different cattle, and I had a very broad understanding of, like, the different breeds of cattle and how to breed them. So one thing that always caught my attention and I was very curious was about how come some cattle produce more milk than others, or how come some cattle produce better quality beef than others. And the more I read about it, the more I realized it was their pedigree, so their genetics, what's in their genes, their DNA. And that kind of encouraged me to go and study genetics at University College Cork in Ireland as an undergraduate. And I came to UCSF because I really wanted to work in Professor David Ruggero's lab. So he's a renowned expert in the field of ribosome biogenesis and cancer, and it was really my interest in, you know, ribosome production and understanding that encouraged me to come to America and pursue my postdoctoral research. So we also have different organisms in the lab that we can test. We can obtain tissue from them. One, we can compare a wild-type tissue to a tissue from an organism that is expressing, you know, a tumor suppressor or an oncogene. So we can look for different patterns in gene expression in these tissues. And the hope would be, if we do find that there's differential expression of different genes or different protein, that we can then use that as a biomarker in the patient samples, that clinicians and doctors may implement that in their clinic and start using these as biomarkers. Science, every day you learn something new. And this is something that I really like. You're always reading something, you're exposed to new literature, there's new exciting findings every day. And this is something that I really, really like about science. Answering a question that no one has addressed before. You know, you have a hypothesis, you want to test it. Is it true or false? If your hypothesis is true, it's like, yes, you know, I got it. King of the world, kind of, you know. What also is rewarding is when you publish your data, other people can look at that data and it may direct how they do their research. You're, you know, telling the world about something new that you have discovered. That's very rewarding. You're adding a new piece to a puzzle. And one really nice thing that I like about our research is that it's biomedical related research. So what you're researching can potentially lead to discovery of biomarkers, or you're looking at something that may translate to patient care in the future. And I think that can be very rewarding. And even just understanding from a basic biology point of view how things work, like, that's something that really interests me, and they're the kind of questions I want to address.